It's actually just 4 in the afternoon and it's this dark. Those people that didn't know, I am from Sweden and it's a beautiful country, especially in the summer. And in winter when it's a lot of snow as well, it can be pretty beautiful. But now in like the middle time when it's just dark, there is no snow. We have sun maybe 1 hour per day. That's what it feels like. It's not that nice. And you need to get your vitamin D, otherwise it's pretty damn depressing. But there was one thing I actually forgot to tell you guys in the previous vlogs. And it's my workout schedule during the weeks. Because I've told you guys what I do during my push and pull workouts, but not necessarily how I structure my full week. So I thought I would mention that now. Let's start with Monday. Monday is a push workout that includes the planche, the push exercises. Then on Tuesday, we have pull, the front lever Victorian training. Wednesday, it is a complete rest day. Most of the times, however, actually it was 2 days ago. It's Friday now when I'm recording this. But 2 days ago, that rest day, I did film some content, which is not the best thing to do. But since I'm a content creator, sometimes my rest days is the only time I have to film videos. From a perspective of getting as much progress as possible, it's not that good. But from a perspective of trying to get both progress and some videos done, it's the best I can do. So that's on Wednesdays. Then on Thursday, it is a freestyle session. So that's in the gym where we do flips. For those who are not that much into calisthenics, we're doing flips, sort of gymnastics. I would never call calisthenics gymnastics, but this part is more towards flips and stuff, and most people understand when you say it like that. So that's on Thursday. Then on Friday, we have a front lever workout. And on Saturday, it's a push workout again. And then on Sundays, we have the freestyle session. So that's basically the full layout. And the problem we have is that freestyle sessions, they require a lot of back strength. It's sort of a pull workout, almost, because all the swings, all the flips, it's a lot of dragging, pulling movements. And therefore, I don't want to do a like pull workout right before a freestyle sessions, because I like, especially like it's 1 hour with car to get there. So it's a lot of dedication to actually go to these sessions. So when you're there, preferably you want to have a good workout. So therefore, I never have a pull workout before my freestyle sessions. And that complicates things, because that means I have to have a pull workout directly after freestyle session. So freestyle on Thursday, I then have a pull workout on Friday, and that can be pretty rough if I'm tired. Therefore, I'm never expecting the Friday pull sessions to be that good. And the same goes for planche workout, actually, since on Sundays I'm having freestyle as well. The day after is a planche workout, and usually I'm a bit tired at those sessions. But this is probably the best I can do. Now after 6 years of training, I figure this is pretty much the best splits. Or at least it works for me. But it's also because I try to be as hybrid as possible when it comes to training. So therefore I want to focus on both freestyle and statics. But if someone would ask me like, how do I get as strong as possible or as good in calisthenics as possible, only want to focus on one thing, progress is going to come way faster. So if I didn't do any freestyle and only focus on planche training, front lever training, I can schedule that over a full week instead. Probably add another rest day instead and have actually 2 rest days and only train 5 times per week. And I think that would be way more beneficial for gaining strength. But from a hybrid perspective, if you want to have both freestyle and statics, you have to combine it in the best way possible. That's why I have the schedule I have. But now, this was a pretty short trip because I parked the car pretty damn close to the train station, and it's not far to the gym from the train station. So now we are here. And the schedule for today is gonna be a front lever workout. And we're still on the deload part, so I think it's gonna be pretty good. Not too intense, but still some nice exercises. And to switch it up, I actually haven't warmed up yet. So I might bring you on that journey as well. To start off, I usually do some rope skipping for roughly 2 minutes or until I break a sweat, but that's pretty much the limit. And then after that, I'm gonna do some active stretching and a little bit of, you know, small handstand and stuff like that. You will see. But first off, 2 minutes rope skipping. I think it's more towards 5 minutes, the rope skipping, not 2 minutes, more towards 5 minutes. And now on to the active stretching. Why I haven't shown too much warm-ups before is because some movements just look ridiculous, also extremely boring in my opinion. It's useful, so I'm definitely not advising anyone not to warm up. When I was younger, or super young, let's say, about 15 years old, I barely warmed up. But at the same time, when I did more basics, like pull-ups and just dips, I used to start with just bodyweight reps. And that to some degree is a form of warm-up, if you just do one exercise really light before moving on to bigger weights. But doing like a full planche light, it's almost impossible. Maybe I like triple bands. So now later on, I started to do way more warm-ups. And all warm-ups are dynamic, so I'm not doing like any static stretching. Otherwise, I obviously would be in split. Some wrist, probably the most important, especially if you're doing planche. Today is a front lever session though, so they're not gonna be as important, but I still always warm up my wrists. Then some leans. So just putting slight pressure on the wrist, not over exaggerating. I'm trying to twist my biceps forward. Now onto the more movement. Bit more for the back. I don't know if this is a yoga position. It's a good warm up. Now onto a skill that is super hard. It's to actually sit like this. I don't know if you can see that. Everything is dark here, so I blend in. Just opening up. And I am extremely unflexible. I've never enjoyed stretching, and I'm paying the price now of being really stiff. So in freestyle and stuff like that, I never do like dislocate, and in statics as well, I can't even do a handstand press. It definitely requires some strength as well, but I'm not even close to having the flexibility enough to do it. Some other skills as well, like V-sit for me. Maybe it's just that I'm weak in stomach, might be. But I'm also like, you know, touching the feet, I can, in a good day, I can touch my feet if I'm standing up. But in the worst days, like halfway. Next up, some twisting. Oof, when you hear the back cracking. Oh, I know it's doing something. Final one, just doing taps. Today was pretty decent. Now I can actually touch the floor. And then this, like imitating a helicopter. And then a bit more specific for the front lever. Just gonna do 20 raises up, locked arms. I think that's pretty good for now. I got my double band setup ready. Since it's deload, I'm using one resistance band. It's 10 to 30 kg, and the other one I think is 5 to 15 kg. So I have both of them just to decrease the intensity. And we're starting off with front lever pull-ups today. Whoa, pretty good grip, pretty good set. I don't know if you can tell though, but I am a bit tired today. I didn't get my 8 hours, more like 5.5 hours of sleep, which is really bad. And yeah, I should aim to get more. Now I couldn't, like I arrived late yesterday home and I have studies starting extremely early in the morning, so I had to be up at 5 in the morning. Which is just insane. So it's hard to, you know, change that, but we do the best from it. So even though I'm a bit tired today, at least it's deload, so it's not gonna be too intense on the body. Let's go shirtless because we need all the energy we can get. This is for self-confidence, feeling strong. That's why I train without it. And if I'm doing a video, it do definitely look better for the video as well. So it's a win-win scenario. Oh. Yeah, I'm glad I'm getting a lot of help, because at least we can get our 8 to 9 reps. This is not good. Come on, Simon. Okay. It's weird though with deload, like ever since I think Tuesday, my body has been super tired. Maybe other factors as well, but it's almost like my body knows that it's time to rest, so it just shuts down. So even though it's deload, everything feels heavy. On to set number 2. This is literally the profile picture of the music I'm listening to. You know that if the picture gives you nightmares, that's some dope ass music. Oof. Oh, it's over. And that is tough. Like, even if it may look like it's really good form and everything, it probably is, but it feels like shit. I think a lot of people can relate to that. Like, even though you're doing exercises as you usually do, you still feel like shit, you feel weak. And that, in the end of the day, is, you know, what sets your mood. So, yeah, it is a bit boring to feel weak, but hopefully next week after this deload, I will actually get some benefits from doing it. Or I know I will. That's why I'm going through this piece of hell. But it's gonna be worth it. Just to have a bit more fun, I'm actually gonna switch up the next exercise. It was supposed to be Victorian on parallels, which I've been doing for a while. But I'm gonna try to do them in the rings. It's way harder, but why not try it? Since the workout is a bit boring today, I want to switch it up so actually feel some joy, or at least try something new. That's also exciting. I'm actually though gonna reduce the leverage arm, if that was what you call it. So I'm gonna put the arm through the band or through the stripes and then hold the rings. So the pressure is gonna be here, which is gonna make it easier than doing Victorian like here. That's like, you know, top hold front lever with straight arm sat, and I can't do that. But this I will at least try. Oh, I don't know, maybe something. Didn't feel like I got, you know, leaned back enough, but I'm gonna check the video and see if I can change something for the next set. I checked my last video and I do need to get my chest a bit more up. I think I'm gonna try to also to pull the arms in towards the body, see if I can hold here. But otherwise, it was a good first attempt. This is extremely hard, like balance wise and strength wise especially, because being able to lean backwards and at the same time push, different level. I don't think that was clean at all, but it was fun to try. I want to do a clean Victorian hold as well, just for that muscle connection. It's gonna be 10 seconds here. Since I'm getting a lot of help, that should be pretty damn doable. Thank you. Oof. I'm also counting everything in my head, so it might not be perfect, but it's good. I'm training the counting so I can actually be good at counting for a competition. Because at that point, I really need to be able to count to 3 seconds, otherwise I'm getting 0 holds and 0 points. We are at the final exercise for the rings. We have pull-ups afterwards, so not really the final for the day, but for the rings. And it's gonna be front lever top hold. What I focus on in this one is to get the hips as far up as possible, almost like overextended. So it feels like I'm extremely bent, but in reality, this is how it feels. But when you actually do it, you sort of just get up here, and that's a good form. So I try to overextend, and then just gravity has its effect, and I actually get into the good form. And all of these static holds, is you almost forget to breathe. But it's like these small sips, and so that's also affecting the hold. If you're not breathing, you're gonna get super low stamina, and it's gonna be pretty short sets. Oh, definitely better than first one. I got myself 30 kg for the final pull-ups. It's gonna be 2 sets, 8 repetitions. I'm expecting it to be pretty heavy today, since the rest of the workout has been pretty damn tough. But we're gonna push through it. I'm gonna tell you, the best part about being a big freestyle athlete is that when I'm heavy, the percentage that I'm actually pulling up is way less compared to my body weight than if I were to be, you know, let's say 60 kg. If I do 30 kg, that's 50% of the total weight, which is pretty much. But for me, since I'm 86 kg, 30 kg percentage wise isn't that much. Still a lot of weight though. Holding false grip and it tears the hand in half, almost like it's gonna rip. On to the final set. Even though it's been a pretty damn tough day, I'm still pretty ripped. I've been sticking to my diets. I haven't mentioned too much about food, but I'm gonna do that in another vlog, I think. Sticking to the diet, so I'm pretty ripped, pretty good form. So let's get some back shots for the final pull-ups. Pretty damn decent. They were a bit slower this time, but we still managed to do 8 of them. This workout is coming to a wrap, but last time I did promise you to look up some flexing poses, so that's what I'm doing right now, and we're gonna try some of them. Got one here. Let's see if we can imitate it. Probably not the same at all. You can see it was Sam Sulek. Yeah, not even close. Then we have another one. This one is a one arm up, one arm flex. I think that was a bit better. Then we have some bicep flexing. Let's give that one a shot. Looks like they are pulling back. I don't know, still bad, but a bit better than last time, I think. Then we have a back flex, which is really hard. I'm gonna give it a shot. Maybe, or it looks, just looks weird as fuck. That's probably most likely. And then we have my favorite that I've been doing for a while. It's the double arm. Which is a bit more familiar. Probably gonna need to look at some video tutorials on actually how to get into the flex position, and we might get a bit better at that. But with that being said, this workout is going for a wrap, and it wasn't the best one. A bit tired today. I was still pushed through it, did some variations. Tomorrow is the last day of this deload, and after that, it's back on track, which I'm really looking forward to. So I will see you guys in another video.